Good evening, students. In previous class, we were discussing about swing components. Let us continue with the discussion. In today's class, we are going to discuss about all the other buttons. We discussed about J buttons, J text field, and all other components. Today, we are going to discuss about radio buttons. So, what are radio buttons? Radio buttons are used for when user wants to give only one option at a time. When you have to read the option in terms of only one option at a time from the user, in that case you can make use of radio button. You might have noticed usually your gender will be read as radio button, either male or female. Any one of those options you can select, and these are supported by J radio button class, which extend J toggle button. Okay. And J radio button provides you a constructor J radio button string str. So string, whatever you're passing within the open and closing parenthesis, that is the label for your button. Okay. And only one of this button in the group can be selected at a time. You can also give two to three, more than three radio buttons, but you can select only one option. It is like multiple choice questions. You can give four options and you are going to select only one option. Okay. And for there is an example. If user presses radio button in that group, any previously selected button in that group is automatically deselected. Okay, if you are having four options, first time you select first one, but you felt that that option is not correct, so you select the last option. So in that case, the first option is deselected. Okay, and the J radio button generates action event, item event, and change event each time the button selection changes. What is action event? By selecting that button, you're going to perform some action through your event handling. Okay. And your event handling supports action listener interface, and using get action command, you can display the result of the action taken whenever event is generated. Get action command is nothing but if you're having four options, and if you have selected first option, it is going to return the first option, whatever you have selected. Okay. And let us see how this radio button works with an example program. Fine. Now this is the program which makes use of radio button. Fine. If you use J frames, okay, you can see radio button here. Radio button, drag and drop that. Are you able to see? This is your radio button. You can drag and drop any number of radio button as per your requirements. So when you select it, what are the options? Selecting and deselecting. Any one of these can be selected, not all of them. If you have selected this one first, and if you have deselected it, if you have selected one more, the second one, then the first one is going to be deselected. Fine. So there are n number of properties with it. Now let us understand how this is working. Okay. There is a program. This program is given in your textbook. Please execute and see how to understand how it is working. We have already discussed about creating the flow layout, and here we are creating the object of J radio button. In the same way how you create object for other components like J button B1, J text field T1, something like that, you can also create object of J radio button, and by passing the string as the parameter. So this is going to be the name for B1, the first radio button, and this is going to be the name for second radio button. It is going to display on the screen. A is going to display after the button, and B is going to display after the another radio button, and C is going to display after the third radio button. So we are creating three radio buttons. Okay, and we are registering every radio button with the event handling method, that is add action listener method. Okay, here we are doing registration of source with the event listener. Fine, in all the three buttons, and after that adding these buttons to the screen. Okay, it is required you to add this button to the screen. So we are adding all the buttons to the screen one by one. Okay, If you don't add it, it is not going to appear on the window, on the output window. That is why it is very much important to add this. Fine. After that, we are creating one more object of type button group, and we are adding all these radio buttons into that. If you don't do like this, when you select second radio button, it is not going to deselect the first one. So to establish the link between all the radio buttons, we are creating button group. Okay, and this is the label. We have given the name select one. Fine. This is what we are going to display on the screen. This is the text to be displayed on the label. Fine. And we are adding that label to the screen. Fine. And this is the action to be performed when you select any radio button. What we are doing? We are modifying the text inside your J label, and we are displaying you selected plus get action command. So it is going to get the details of which button is selected. Now let us run this program and see how it is working. Shift F6. It is still running. Yeah, we got the output. Let me share that output window to everybody. Yes. Now you are able to see the output of J radio button. Here we created three radio buttons with the text A, B, C, right? And this is what we are passing within open and closing parentheses while creating the object of J radio button. That's why it is creating three radio buttons, and this is your label. Select one, what we are displaying, that is your label, J label. Okay, when I select A, it is going to display you selected A. How we got that A? Using your get action command. Okay, using that method, we are able to read the button text whichever it is selected. If I select B, is going to display you selected B. You have to notice one thing: when I select B, A is automatically deselected. When I select C, B is automatically deselected. Why? Because we have added all these buttons to a button group. Fine. This is about your radio button. You can notice the difference. Only one option can be selected at a time. Fine. And we are going to display whatever we have selected on the screen. If you notice in your program, what is this? Get action command. So it is going to return whatever text is there inside that particular radio button. It means whichever radio button you have selected, it's going to return that radio button. And we are going to display you selected A. Whenever we selected A, whenever we selected B, this is called as event handling. So you are going to perform some event on the radio button, and it is going to call your action performed method and execute this particular statement. In this one, what we are doing, we are modifying the J label text, and we are going to display you selected, and whatever command we have selected, that is going to be retrieved using get action command, and we are going to display that text, you selected A, you selected B, you selected C, something like this. Okay.